Hello everyone, welcome to this lecture. I am Amlan Das. Today I will discuss about Debye's theory of specific heat of solid. Okay. Let us consider a solid crystal composed of n atoms. These atoms can vibrate with 3n normal modes with frequencies nu 1, nu 2, dot dot, nu 3n. Now, in Einstein's model, it was assumed that all these atoms vibrate with the same frequency independently of each other. But Debye rejected the idea of independent vibration of the atom. He assumed that solid is a homogeneous elastic medium which as a whole can vibrate with 3n normal modes of different frequencies. Debye also assumed that there is an upper limit or cutoff frequency nu d beyond which there is no modes of vibration of solid is. And this cutoff frequency nu d is called Debye frequency. Okay, so nu d is called Debye frequency. Now, according to quantum theory, a wave generated in elastic vibration of a body may be considered as a particle called phonon. Okay. Phonon. A wave generated in elastic vibration of a body may be considered as a phonon. Thus, a solid can be regarded as a gas of phonon. Now, phonons are identical and indistinguishable particles with spin 0. So, phonons have spin 0. So, they are bosons. Okay. So, phonons are bosons. And so, they obey Bose-Einstein statistics. They obey Bose-Einstein statistics. Okay. Now, in elastic vibration of a continuous solid, two kinds of waves are excited. First is one type of longitudinal wave. Okay, so first is one type of longitudinal wave. Longitudinal wave, and second is two types of transverse wave. So, second is two types of transverse wave. In elastic vibration of a continuous solid, two kinds of waves are excited. First kind is one type of longitudinal wave, and second is two types of transverse wave. Now we know that the number of modes of vibration of type A and type B, kind A and kind B, contained in volume V and in the frequency range nu and nu plus d nu is first kind. For the first kind, number of modes of vibration is V into 4 pi nu square d nu by CL cube, and Number of modes of vibration for second kind is 2 into V into 4 pi nu square d nu by Ct cube. Okay. Here, CL is the velocity of longitudinal wave and Ct is the velocity of transverse wave. Okay. Now, since there are two types of transverse wave, so here we multiply 2. Okay. So, this is the number of modes of vibration in the volume V in the frequency range nu and nu plus d nu. And this is the number of modes of vibration of transverse wave in the volume V in the frequency range nu and nu plus d nu. Okay. So, the total number of modes of vibration in the frequency range nu and nu plus d nu is g nu d nu equals to this plus this. Okay. So, this is equals to 4 pi common 1 by CL cube plus 2 by CT cube into nu square d nu. Suppose this is equation 1. Okay. So, this is the number of modes of vibration in the frequency range nu and nu plus d nu. Okay. Now, from this equation, we can write g nu proportional to nu square. Okay. Now, if we plot g nu versus nu square graph, that is, if we plot g nu along x axis and nu square along y axis, then we will get this type of graph. So, this is g nu versus nu square graph. Okay. G nu versus nu square graph. So, this is the number of modes of vibration in the frequency range nu and nu plus d nu. So, the total number of modes of vibration is integration of g nu d nu. Okay. So, total number of modes of vibration is integration of g nu d nu. Now, total number of modes of vibration is 3n. So, we may write integration g nu d nu equals to 3n. Now, this implies that the upper limit of frequency cannot be infinite but should be cut off at a finite upper value. This cut off frequency nu d is called Debye frequency. Okay. And the lower limit of frequency is of course 0. Okay. Hence, the limit of this integration will be integration 0 to nu d. Okay. Now, here we put the value of g nu d nu from equation 1. Okay. So, here we put the value of g nu d nu or integration 0 to nu d 4 pi v 1 by CL cube plus 2 by CT cube into nu square d nu equals to 3n or integration 0 to nu d or the constant term is this, so 4 pi v 1 by CL cube plus 2 by CT cube into integration 0 to nu d nu square d nu equals to 3n or 4 pi v 1 by cl cube plus 2 by ct cube into, if we integrate this then we will get this is equals to nu d cube by 3 equals to 3n. Okay. Or nu d cube equals to 9n by 4 pi into 1 by cl cube plus 2 by ct cube. Okay. So nu d cube is this. Hence Debye frequency nu d equals to 9n by 4 pi into 1 by cl cube plus 2 by ct cube to the power 1/3. Okay. So this is the Debye frequency nu d. Now if we put the value of this term, then we can determine the Debye frequency nu d. Okay. Now we know that the average energy of an oscillator of frequency nu at temperature T is epsilon bar equals to h nu by e to the power h nu by kT minus 1. Okay. We know that average energy of an oscillator is this. So the total energy of the crystal is E equals to integration 0 to nu d into epsilon bar into g nu d nu. Okay. Total energy of the crystal is E equals to integration 0 to nu d epsilon bar into g nu d nu. Okay. Now here we put the value of epsilon bar and g nu d nu. Okay. So total energy is equals to integration 0 to nu d. Now first we put the value of g nu d nu. So this is equals to 4 pi v 1 by cl cube plus 2 by ct cube into nu square, and the value of epsilon bar is h nu by e to the power h nu by kT minus 1 into d nu. Okay. So this is E. This can be written as this is equals to 4 pi V 1 by CL cube plus 2 by CT cube integration 0 to nu d H nu cube into by e to the power H nu by KT minus 1 into d nu. Okay. Now the value of this term, from this equation we can see that value of this term is, that is 4 pi b into 1 by cl cube plus 2 by ct cube is 9n by nu b cube. So replacing this by 9n by nu d cube and h is constant, so we can write here h into integration 0 to nu d nu cube by e to the power h nu by kT minus 1 into d nu. Okay. So, total energy of the crystal is 9 NH by nu d cube into integration 0 to nu, nu d, nu cube by e to the power h nu by kt minus 1 into d nu. Okay. Suppose this is equation 2. Now, let h nu by kt equals to x. Okay. Let x equals to h nu by kt or nu equals to x kt by h. So, d nu equals to kt by h into dx. And let x d equals to h nu d by kt. And also let theta d equals to h nu d by k. Okay. So, let theta d equals to h nu d by k. So, using theta d, x d can be written as, so x d equals to theta d by t. Okay. So, using this, equation 2 can be written as E equals to 9 NH by nu d cube into integration. Now here theta d, having the unit of temperature, is a characteristic temperature and is known as Debye temperature. Okay. So theta d is known as Debye temperature. Debye temperature. Okay. It has the unit of temperature. So, using this, equation 2 can be written as 9 NH by nu d cube into integration 0 to, limit is x d, okay, 0 to x d, and the value of nu cube is x kt by h cube, and the value of d nu is kt by h into dx by e to the power x minus 1. Okay. So, this is E. Or E equals to 9 NH by nu d cube, and here is kt by h to the power 4 integration 0 to x d x cube dx by e to the power x minus 1. Okay. Now, this can be written as, this is equals to 9 NKT into K by H nu D cube into T cube into integration 0 to X D X cube DX by e to the power X minus 1. Okay. Now, we know that theta D is h nu d by k. Okay. So, this can be written as, this is equals to 9 nkt into t by theta d, because this is 1 by theta d. So, t by theta d cube into integration 0 to x d x cube dx by e to the power x minus 1. Suppose this is equation 3. So, this is the total energy of the crystal. Okay. This is the total energy of the crystal. Now, here we discuss two cases. First is at high temperature range and second is at low temperature range. Okay. So first we discuss at high temperature range. So at high temperature, at high temperature, x t is much greater than theta d. Okay. Now x is h nu by kt. Okay. Now under this condition, that is when t is much greater than theta d, x is very small. X is very small, and we can write x tends to 0. Okay. When t is much greater than theta d, x tends to 0. X is very small. So under this condition, total energy of the crystal becomes E equals to 9 nkt into t by theta d cube integration 0 to x d into x cube dx by, now if we expand this series, then we will get 1 plus x plus x square by factorial 2 plus x cube by factorial 3. But at when x tends to 0, we can neglect higher order terms. Okay. So we can write 1 plus x plus dot 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 minus 1. Okay. When x is very small, we can write this. Here plus 1 minus 1 will be cancelled, and at last we get this is equals to 9 nkt into t by theta d cube into integration 0 to x d and x square dx. Okay. So this is equals to 9 nkt into t by theta d cube. Now if we integrate this, then we will get this is equals to x d cube by 3. So this is equals to 3 nkt into t by theta d cube into the value of x d is, we know that x d equals to theta d by t, so this is equals to theta d by t cube. So this two term will cancel, and at last we get this is equals to 3 nkt. Now n into k is capital R, that is gas constant. So we may write this is equals to 3RT, since n into k is R, gas constant. Okay. So at when temperature is high, that is when T is much greater than theta d, total energy of the solid is 3RT. And so the molar specific heat CV equals to del E del T at constant volume V. Okay. So this is equals to 3R. So molar specific heat CV equals to 3R. And this is Dulong-Petit's law. Okay. This is Dulong-Petit's law. Thus at high temperature, that is when temperature is much greater than theta d, Debye's theory gives the same result as that of classical theory. Okay. Now we discuss at low temperature range. Okay. At low temperature, at low temperature, T is much less than theta d. Okay. And so x d equals to theta d by t. When t is much less than theta d, x d tends to infinity. Okay. So under this condition, total energy becomes E equals to 9 n kT into T by theta d cube into integration 0 to, the value of x d is now infinity. So integration will be 0 to infinity into x cube dx by e to the power x minus 1. Okay. So this is equals to 9 n kT into T by theta d cube. Now the value of this integration, that is integration 0 to infinity x cube dx by e to the power x minus 1, is pi to the power 4 by 15. If we calculate this, then we will get this is equals to pi to the power 4 by 15. Since integration 0 to infinity x cube dx by e to the power x minus 1 equals to pi to the power 4 by 15. If we calculate this, then we will get this result. So this is equals to 3 by 5 pi to the power 4 n k by theta t cube into t to the power 4. Okay. So at low temperature, the energy of the crystal is this. So the molar specific heat Cv equals to del E del T at constant volume V. Okay. So this is equals to 3 by 5 pi to the power 4 nk by theta d cube into 4 t cube. Okay. So this is equals to 12 by 5 pi to the power 4 nk into t by theta d cube. Okay. Now n into k is r, that is gas constant. So this is equals to 12 by 5 pi to the power 4 into r t by theta d cube. So at low temperature, value of the specific heat is this. Now here 12 by 5 pi to the power 4 r is constant and theta d is also constant. So we may write Cv is proportional to T cube. Okay. And this is Debye's T cube law for the specific heat of solid. Okay. So this is known as Debye's T cube law for the specific heat of solid. Now, this equation shows that according to this law, specific heat Cv at low temperature decreases as the cube of temperature instead of exponentially as in Einstein's theory. Okay. Now, the decrease is therefore less rapid than Einstein curve, and the agreement with the experiment is much better. Okay. Now, although Debye's theory is based on the theory of elastic wave in a continuous isotropic homogeneous medium, the experimental values of specific heat of many crystalline solids are in good agreement with Debye's theory for T less than theta d by 50. Okay. Thus we discuss Debye's theory for the specific heat of solid. Okay. Thank you for watching this video.